What I'd like to talk about today are changes to the permanent establishment article under the various tax treaties that govern whether companies are subject to tax in a particular country. That standard has been in existence for over 100 years, but it was deemed to be too liberal by many countries. And in connection with the OECD's BEPS project, there were proposals to alter the standard, to expand the conditions under which companies could have permanent establishments, either through the actions of agents in a country, or through engaging in activities that went beyond preparatory or auxiliary activities. It's important because companies are going to find that they may be subject to taxation locally in foreign countries where previously they were not. Well, multinational companies have to understand how they interact with customers in a country and whether employees of affiliates are actually engaging in activities on behalf of a non-resident enterprise. They also have to consider the importance of their activities within a country, whether they go beyond what would be considered preparatory or auxiliary. And they really have two choices. First, to the extent that they can change their commercial model or alter the way that people do business, they may be able to avoid a permanent establishment. But if they can't do that, they should understand what their exposure is and what their filing obligations are.